What's up, guys? In today's video, one of the things you are going to be learning is how to place your stop loss, the right way to place your stop loss. You know, one of the challenges that traders face is ability to set their stop loss the right way. So in this video, you are going to be learning how to set your, especially how I set my stop loss in the right way. So today you are going to be learning the steps we are going to follow to set. We are going to be using ATR to set this stop loss, ATR indicator. So pay attention very well. Once you are here, imagine that you want to set a stop loss, or whenever each pair, whether you're trading stock or you're trading currency, whenever you want to set your stop loss, I'm going to choose in a pair to give you an example of how you're going to use to set stop loss. Apply it in any pair you are trading. For instance, now if I come down here and I click on USD JPY, I'll click on open chart. So if you are here, if you want to, let me go back here. Let me remove the ATR so that I will show you how you can set it up. Okay, as you can see, we have a clean chart here. So this chart here, this chart you are seeing, imagine that after your analysis, you have analyzed and you know the direction you want to take. For instance, if after analyzing, I want to sell this pair. I'm giving you an instance. I'm not telling you to sell now, but I'm showing you how you can set your stop loss. So if you want to sell this pair, for instance, imagine that maybe your analysis tell you to sell. As you can see, it's coming down. Maybe your analysis tell you to sell once at this point. So if you want to sell this market at this point, one of the things you can do to set your stop loss, the first thing is to come down to this place. When you come to this place, click on it. As you click on it, to take you to this page. In this page, click on this place. As you click on this point, come down here and put average true range, which is otherwise known as ATR, average true range. Once you click on it, it will take you here. Here, what you will see here, you see period. In this place, you will see period. This period here, you have 14. This is default setting. We have 14 here. You can use this default setting, or you can change it to a different number. But for the sake of this video, we're going to be using default setting. But each time I'm trading on a higher time frame, like daily time frame, I like to change it to 20. The reason being that we have 20 days in a month of trading, so 20 trading days, so I will change it to 20. But for the sake of this video, remember that I changed it to that way, it's just my own way. Each time I'm trading on a higher time frame, in a daily time frame, but if I'm trading on a normal time frame, you can do that. Does not mean that using 20 is the right one. You can use any one, you just use default setting, which is 14, as it pleases you. So I'm going to be using this 14 for the sake of this video. And now, once you choose here, or you just leave it in default setting, click done. As you click done, as you can see, we have ATR. As you can see the number here. So this line is the line of ATR. So right now, remember, our goal is to set our stop loss. So once you set your stop loss, what you need to do is, imagine that you want to sell at this price, which is instant execution, for instance. So you want to sell at this price we have here. So, but you are confused on how to set your stop loss. So you have been setting your stop loss. So this 14, you see 14 here. What this 14 do, the aim of this, the 14 here, what it do is that it calculates the 14 candles. If you calculate this, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The movement of this candle, that is what this thing will calculate. The movement of 14 candles, you understand? If you use 20, it will calculate the movement of 20 candles. Are you getting me? Then use it now to show you how you can check the volatility of the market to identify where the stop loss will be. If the movement, as you can see, there are push up, like the movement, the market is volatile, like it's highly volatile, then the stop loss will be wide. because it's trying to give you some room because of the nature of the movement of the market at a particular time. So, but if you notice that maybe the market is choppy, then the stop loss will be tighter. But if it is moving higher, then the ATR will be wider. You understand? Your stop loss will be, you know, have some space. Reason is because of the movement of the market. So ATR take calculation of the movement of the market within the 14 candles to determine the ATR you have here. So how do you set your stop loss with this information? What you do is, if you look at this chart, you discover that as market push up to this area, so this is the recent high, you understand, from this point now is here, and you want to sell at this price. So what you do is this: you come down here, click on this plus sign. As you click on this plus sign, you drag this plus sign, place it on top of here. Place it on top of here. As you place it on top of here, using your phone, then you copy. As you place it on top of here, use a paper or find something, copy this number, this line, this horizontal line showing you a number. Copy this number here. Once you copy this number, then come back and copy this one. Add this one to this one, not this one. As you can see, this one here, the high is here. Copy the number you have here, then copy the number you have here. Add it together. Once you add it together, it should give you about, for instance, to giving you about, let's say, 109.100, which is around here. If you add the number together, you can do the calculation, just add it together around this. So your stop loss now, you use this number. By the time you add the first one, which is this line, as I tell you, copy it, then copy this and add it together. Whatever value you use is what you are going to be using as your stop loss, which means you are going to be placing it in the stop loss column. So if you add this to the one you just copied from this line, then it will give you 109.100. So your stop loss will appear here. Then when you want to place a trade, the next thing you do is you come down here, click here, that number you copy as your stop loss, you put it here, which is, for instance, now from what we just did, now you just type 109.100. As you can see, I have put in my stop loss. So this is for what? Instant execution. You have put in your stop loss. Remember, what we use that to do is to calculate stop loss. So if you know your take profit, you put your take profit here. Stop loss is this size, take profit is here. So let's go back. If you come back, remember you have just calculated our stop loss, which is, by if I place the tail, you see a dot line here showing you that your stop loss appear here, which means it's giving you, in case markets come back a bit, so that you to still keep you in the market. So your take profit now, based on your strategy, depends on your strategy. You know, if you're a trend follower, you know that you follow this trend as market moves. But if you are a swing trader, you know that your take profit should be the next resistance level. Like from here, you can take your profit at this point. All you do is just, you come back here, click on this thing, you see the plus sign. Then you can take your profit, maybe here, the first take profit because of this stuff, maybe here. Here can be your first take profit, as you can see it around here. Or you can also use here as a take profit. So whichever way, depending on your strategy, or you can see the next swing. The next swing means from here to here, you take your profit here. You understand, the last, where they have the last low. Then from this market move down to this area, then you take your profit, which means this will serve as your stop, your take profit. Remember, you have already copied your stop loss, which is that first thing you copied, which will be around here. Then, which means once you come down here and click here, you put your stop loss here. This take profit, I just show you, you can use the next support or resistance level depending. Then put it here, which is served as your take profit. You can use next support, which means if you know, you don't know what is support, then maybe I will do a video on that. But just identify your next resistance or support level. If you are selling, you look for support level to be your first take profit. We have second take profit. Then set it like that. That is how you can be using it. ATR is a very good way indicator you can use to set your stop loss. Always apply it in any pair, whichever pair, even if you come down here, any pair you are trading, make sure, for instance, if you click on this pair, come down here, click here, any pair, whether you are buying, if you are buying, just come down here. For instance, if this one now I want to buy, all you need to do, click here, as you click on this plus sign, then come down here, find where is the low. Can use the low, you see market come down here, reach here, so you are using this one as the last low before you move. You understand? If you want to buy it, which means you're going to copy this number, so copy this number, you come down here, copy this one, add the two together, whatever it give you becomes your stop loss, which means you come to here, then put, and after you add the two, any number you see there, after adding it, you put it here as your stop loss. While your take profit should be the next resistant level. So you can see why, you know, markets bounce up to this level, come down here. So this region becomes your take profit. You use here as your take profit because market here is a resistant level. You understand? So that's why you use here as your take profit. So that is how you can be doing it. Just practice this and keep using it. Any pair you are trading, whether you are buying, you are selling, make sure you use the ATL to do whatever thing you want to do. That's how to do it. And make sure you click the subscribe button to support.